Now, I know there's not a lot of auto rifles that you see inside of PvP. Maybe not even inside of PvE that much. Like, for me, the meta inside of PvE is either an aggressive frame pulse rifle or just a really good hand cannon or recluse or mountaintop. Straight up, guys, for those that don't know, mountaintop recluse is probably like the meta inside of PvE. But we're getting off the subject here today, guys. We are looking at an auto rifle that is the Gambit Prime auto rifle, Gnawing Hunger. We've got a couple of rolls here. Neither one of these, I would say, are god roll. They're okay, but I felt like it could get better. So of course, we're gonna talk about recommended rolls. And again, guys, we're going to discuss this from the perspective of PvE and for PvP. So first up, let's take a look at this roll right here. It comes with Arrowhead Break, Drop Mag, and yes, I'm using Drop Mag, even though that doesn't seem like the best magazine perk. But for this instance, I need that extra reload speed because it comes with the traits Auto-Loading Holster, which is kind of garbage, and Kill Clip. Now, I say Auto-Loading Holster is garbage. Come on, guys. It's an auto rifle, and this thing has already got Drop Mag on it. So the reload speed is already pretty quick, if not damn near maxed out. On top of that, it comes with a reload masterwork if I wanted to get really spicy with it. But this is Grimm's account. I didn't want to waste his masterwork course. Now, the main reason why I even reviewed this roll is for two reasons. Number one, I wanted to see it in action with Kill Clip, and I wanted to see it in action with Arrowhead Break. Considering that our recoil direction here is 54, Arrowhead Break does knock that up to about 84, which is pretty vertical. I mean, vertical enough. If you wanted to get really extreme with it, you could throw a counterbalance mod on there too, which would pretty much dang near max out that recoil direction. But I will say, just by itself with Arrowhead Break was plenty enough. Now let's talk about Kill Clip, because that's the big one. Kill Clip on a 600 round per minute auto rifle allows this weapon to jump from 23 per crit and 14 per body to 30 per crit and 19 per body. So the damage bump there is pretty nice. But is it better than this next roll? This one comes with Corkscrew Rifling. Doesn't come with Arrowhead Break, unfortunately. Although, like we just established a second ago, that is obviously the better barrel perk here. It does come with two pretty good magazine perks. Steady Rounds and Accurized Rounds. Now, depending on you, especially for my console players, Steady Rounds, man, I would very much suggest. But as an auto rifle, this weapon will run into some steep damage fall off very quickly. And the moment you do, and we're going to talk about time to kill in just a second, that really starts to mess with you. That's probably my biggest complaint, because 600 round per minute auto rifles are actually in a pretty good spot. They could be pretty decent. The issue is damage fall off pretty much screws it over. Now, the other trait on this weapon is tap the trigger, which is kind of like, it's whatever. It's an auto rifle. You don't really need tap the trigger. Like, I like tap the trigger on certain things. They're really good for one-hit kill weapons, things like fusion rifles. I really like it on some of our aggressive sidearms, as it doesn't stop proccing, but it's kind of whatever here. But the other perk, multi-kill clip. Reloading grants increased damage based on the number of rapid kills made beforehand. So again, guys, today's video is not necessarily hitting the god roll. It's more or less us trying to find the god roll. What is the roll you should be looking for? And the first thing that came up for me when I was on Grimm's account was multi-kill clip versus kill clip. Which one of these perks is better, specifically catering to a 600 round per minute auto. So when we take a look at multi-kill clip inside of PvE, we see that the first stack there does 33% extra damage, then goes up to 66%, and then so on to 100%. Now this seems pretty nasty, and it is, especially inside of PvE, but that's not the case inside of PvP. That's actually been toned down. So the first stack inside of PvP is like 17%, and I didn't have people to test it out with, but if it's gonna go in that same linear fashion, the next stack should be 34% and fully capping out at 51%. Now for Kill Clip inside of PvE, this one actually gets a buff of somewhere between 52 and 53% after activating Kill Clip. You get that immediate jolt of bonus damage upon reloading, and it only requires one kill. But inside of PvE, of course, this is toned back a little more as well, as this only gives us a 30% buff, which is still a very substantial buff considering it only requires one kill as well. So which one of these perks is the best perk here on Gnawing Hunger? For me, guys, Kill Clip is the superior trait for PvP. But for PvE, hands down, multi-kill clip is definitely the one I would be picking up. Just simply because you've got a lot of ads in front of you, the 600 round per minute auto rifle already has a very large magazine. Getting multi-kills before reloading shouldn't be too difficult. Now, depending on the scenario and whatever it is you're going against, obviously is going to be the biggest deciding factor on which one of these weapons or traits would be the perfect choice for you. But multi-kill clip is definitely what I would be utilizing more inside of PvE. But let's get to what I want to talk about. Is gnawing hunger the way? Is this an auto rifle you should be using? Like I said a second ago, guys, autos are actually not in a terrible position. I mean, when we look at time to kills for these weapons, adaptive auto rifles have a 0.8 second time to kill. What screws them is damage falloff. And I don't have like a range of which damage falloff starts, but the thing about it is, it's steep. It's super, super steep. And so once you hit that damage falloff range, man, oh my God, it's not this nice, pretty linear damage falloff every, you know, 2-3 meters. It's just like, bam, nothing. Which is why when you get into like mid-range gunfights and you're shooting with your auto rifle, it's not registering any hits, and that's by design. So it's unfortunate. And I know a lot of people say auto rifles are no skilled weapons, and I say to hell with those people, because I like auto rifles, especially these 600s. And I was really hoping gnawing hunger was gonna be more of a force to be reckoned with. And it can be with the right rolls, but in this scenario, I still feel like it's gonna have some difficulties dealing with certain weapons, specifically like hand cannons on PC, pulse rifles on console, you know what I mean? And that's just because of the steep amount of damage falloff that you get. Now let's get into god rolls. If you wanna actually get the roll to be using inside of PvP, I would actually go for a kill clip roll, just like I just talked about, and probably Zen Moment. Now, the reason why I say Zen Moment, especially for my controller users and console users, you really wanna knock up Zen together with accurized rounds. Now, I know that seems to go against what we normally say, because we always like to advocate for stability, but considering how much damage falloff affects this weapon, I want to load out range a little more. Arrowhead break doesn't help out in range either, so you really want to just kind of give yourself a little more range there and not hurt it with that steady round stat that actually drops our range by -5. So Zen Moment, kill clip together with Akaras rounds and Arrowhead break, that's exactly what I would look for, actually. And maybe I would actually take that, combine it with a ranged masterwork. Maybe a stability masterwork. I really don't know. I don't know where the weapon would sit in terms of like damage follow. Now for PvE, it's really hard to promote any auto rifle inside of PvE outside of Breakneck, right? This is present in the energy slot though. And this opens up that kinetic slot if you wanted to use Arbalest, if you wanted to use Mountaintop. So in some ways, you can try to achieve what Breakneck already does way better inside that kinetic slot, but instead inside this energy slot. But it just won't, to me, it's just not gonna come to par. You know, it's just not gonna be as good. Multi-kill clip to me would be a go-to trait, simply because it gives you that +100% damage on that multi-kill clip x3. And considering that Breakneck already does everything that this auto rifle can do and better with Rampage, I would rather just go with multi-kill clip. And probably take multi-kill clip, you could put it with something like auto-loading holster or maybe field prep, probably field prep, I don't know. Try field prep maybe. You get a faster reload, stow, and ready speed when crouching. So after you get the third kill, you just crouch, reload, boom, instant reload. Could be pretty good. That's kind of the route I would go. And of course, magazine perks there, anything that can buff your magazine size, maybe your reload speed, if you wanted to go something like tactical mag. That's what I would try though. Field prep, multi-kill clip, one of those perks, arrowhead break, and maybe still a ranged masterwork, even though it's PvE. So guys, that is Gnawing Hunger. Thank you, Grim, for letting us get on your account, man, and playing with it. It's an auto rifle. I enjoyed it. I actually enjoyed it so much, I'm probably gonna look for the god roll I just mentioned for PvP for console. If you happen to be a console player and you got this on your account, let me know. I might for real get on your account and play with it, because I wanna see how it performs. For PC, even when playing with the controller, and some of this gameplay is with a controller, the weapon performs good, right? Like, it's accurate, it's got good aim assist, it's got great stats across the board for the most part. The issue is you've got an ace of spades in front of your face, or a last word, that just doesn't miss. So it's really hard for me to recommend auto rifles for PC. But we're gonna re-review this, guys, for console. Don't worry, I'll make sure to jump on that. So if you got that role that I mentioned, guys, feel free to let me know. Fellas and ladies, hey, I like you guys. You know that? I like you guys a lot. I'm feeling kind of peppy today, man. Thank you all for coming and watching. And as always,
slap that like button like your mama told you right.